I just love that physics can explain the world and the weird intricacies of it and the weird quirks of our universe. So there's a rainbow. Physics tells you how that works. Cheerios that stick together. Physics tells you how that happens. I think other people like those other sciences because there are unanswered questions and mysteries, but I was like, I want to know the answer. And physics had answers. When I was thinking about going to MIT, I visited Cambridge and I looked around and I was like, I feel like I can tell which of these people go to MIT. That person looks nerdy. They must be from MIT. I hate it when people look at me and they're like, you don't look like a physicist or something. So I was basically doing exactly to the MIT population what people do to me. That was a good ring. Who was I? I have a YouTube channel about how much I love physics. Like, I'm the queen of the nerds. I didn't have a plan immediately after graduation, which I think was unique at MIT. I'm gonna use the word unique. I felt like it was really stressful. I started this YouTube channel and it was definitely a learning experience for me. I've like forged a career path that's weird and different and have made it work so far. Selfish Diana would say that my favorite part is getting these amazing experiences. Going on the zero-G plane, that was an incredible experience as a human being to get to experience zero gravity. Getting to work with Rodney Mullen, who's an amazing professional skateboarder who just loves science. And he's like, yeah, I'd love to work with you because I love science and I think it's really cool what you're doing. I got recognized by these two little twin 8-year-old girls at an airport recently. They were so excited and their dads were like, thank you so much. They love your videos. I was like, oh my God, this is crazy and amazing. Ah, this is so cool to have impacted those little girls. I had an amazing physics teacher in high school named Kathy Jones. We did so many hands-on demos and experiments that kind of captured your imagination about fascinating phenomena in the world. Having a wider audience and so more views on me, I think gives me the opportunity to be, you know, what Kathy Jones, my physics teacher, was for me, which is like, oh, she's a woman and she's really smart and into physics and she can do physics. I've heard this saying more and more lately that's like, if you can see it, you can be it. There are some amazing women hosting YouTube channels, doing blogs on Twitter, doing public outreach. We're just the start of this wave of women in STEM who are taking over and becoming much more visible. And I'm really excited for that.